inoculant application is a job you can do on your farm. We'll explain the best equipment setup for inoculant in today's Iron Talk. Inoculants are used in a number of crops to introduce nitrogen-forming bacteria to legume crops. On our farm, soybeans are the legume we grow, but for you, it may be any number of legume crops. Soybean inoculant is a term for rhizobia bacteria. They colonize around soybean roots and bring nitrogen in from the air into the plant. The trick is to apply them to the seed and get them into the soil before they perish. Inoculants must be in close proximity to the main taproot of the plant to be the most effective. For this reason, seed-applied treatments are most common. With in-furrow liquid applications, you'll likely need 5 times as much product to equal the results of seed treatments. We've also seen much better results when applying inoculant within hours of planting. Planting seed days or weeks later after treating the seed results in bacterial mortality of up to 90%. But bridging or clumping of seed with liquid treatments is always a concern. Best practice is to spray liquid inoculant on at multiple points in a brush auger or potentially a belt veyor or cup system. The keys are to use multiple nozzles to get improved coverage of the seed, and then to have some sort of mixing as well to coat the seed on all sides. Doing it a few hours in advance of use and running the seed through a brush auger or belt veyor after treating will greatly reduce, if not eliminate, clumping, leading to maximum performance from the inoculant and the seed. When it comes to dry inoculant, there are dry treaters on the market. The challenges have been lumpy, uneven distribution of the product on the seed and a static buildup in the poly hopper. CT applicators have the best technology that we've seen on the market with a stainless steel hopper and a sifter to even out the application. Adding inoculant to legumes like soybeans generally provides a nice return on investment. Doing it yourself is pretty simple, whether you're using a liquid or a dry inoculant. That's all for today's Iron Talk, and now back to the show.